Oh, hello, and Merry Christmas. I'm Jim Sterling, the host of the Jimquisition. Now, it's Christmas Day, as you watch this, unless you didn't bother watching it today because you actually have a family and a life, in which case you're watching it after Christmas Day, but I think the message remains the same. In the United Kingdom, every year on Christmas Day, the Queen gives a speech, reflecting on the year and just having a little bit of a message for us and reminding us what it's all about. And video games, I believe, deserve their own Queen speech. And I am the closest facsimile to the Queen that video games has, so it falls to me. What's 2013 been about? Well, we've seen all sorts of controversies, all sorts of anger and rage. The Jimquisition, of course, has covered most of it. The property of things, ownership, what rights we have as gamers, content creators, consumers, and even game makers has come up a lot. We've talked about things like EA and SimCity and how having always online connections it can ruin a game that you bought at launch, because ultimately these games are being sold to us as services rather than actual products that we bought and own. And the convenience of the user is being placed with a far less emphasis than the control that a company may have over the software. Obviously, we had the Xbox One uproar as well, and that whole issue of Microsoft basically retaining ownership of your entire experience after you've bought it. It was announced to have that always online check-in every 24 hours, where if you don't check in with the game, then the game can't be played, and games that you buy, therefore, having been tied to this online identity, can't be traded in. You basically don't own the game. You buy the right to play the game for until Microsoft decides that you can't. This is a problem that actually has recently come up when it turns out that this check-in is still active for some digital titles like Killer Instinct 3, which is obviously not very good. In a lot of these instances this year, a lot of people have fought back. Gamers united and voiced their displeasure en masse. The Jimquisition, of course, was a video series that covered the Xbox One stuff in great detail and multiple videos. A lot of other people online, most notably guys like Francis on YouTube, pitched in, and games media and game forums and game customers, everybody sort of united and told Microsoft this isn't on. And there was enough pressure to where they listened and relented, and obviously not fully, but as we saw with Killer Instinct 3 recently, took away the requirement for the always online stuff and basically put things back to the way they were, something that Sony capitalized on when people made it clear this is what we want from Sony. And that's wonderful. That's an example of what we can accomplish when we're all together on something as this unified voice. With enough pressure, companies can care and give a shit about you and will alter themselves and will change a course that the gaming public doesn't care for. It's not always guaranteed, and sometimes it's not even for the best, but sometimes, like with the Xbox One, we can see real results, we can see a real change for the good. And I think that's something we should always be mindful of. And there are a lot of people that just throw their arms up and say, it's just business, we shouldn't care, and you know, there's no point making a fuss about anything because they don't listen to us, but they do. I've said before, there's a reason why Electronic Arts got its panties in a bunch when it was named the worst company in America 2 times in a row for 2 years. It's not that the award means anything, it's that it is bad press, and it does matter to them, even if they are a big monolithic company like EA. That does matter. So that kind of pressure is good. obviously the pressure isn't always uniformly a good thing. Again, this is something we've seen examples of this year quite a lot with online harassment of certain individuals within the industry. I'm talking about, obviously, Anita Sarkeesian's one of them. Zoe Quinn, more recently, the developer of Depression Quest. There's been a lot of stories this year about harassment of people. It's not just women as well. You know, many of you would be quick to point out. We had a guy from Treyarch who was quite viciously assaulted online and had his private details found and whatnot. In fact, Call of Duty developers in particular report having all sorts of horrible real-life harassment happening to them over a video game. Phil Fish, after putting up with months and months of attacks, some of which would argue he brought on himself, some of which wouldn't, and that's a different debate. But the end result of the harassment was he is still sticking to his guns with not coming back. He may do eventually, but he left the industry this year, and it's not cool. It's not good, and it does upset me when, in fact, I was recently playing Tearaway on the PS Vita, and when I play a game like Tearaway, which was a game clearly made with a lot of joy, a lot of love, and was made just to give us joy as gamers, just to give us love, just to make us smile, that's actually when I get my most angry, when I think about just what the gaming community as a whole can do. Because, I don't know, it's like a big fuck you to a game like Tearaway, to a game like Kirby, you know, to a game like Pokemon. Just games that are made just with heart and passion and pure, like, love for the industry, love for the art of making a game, love for the people playing the games. These are games designed purely to make us happy, and they're wonderful, and they're some of the best examples of interactive entertainment in the industry. And I feel it just does a disservice to the very idea of gaming that so many of us, when we're not playing these games, then go online and spend our time making other gamers and other game makers feel bad and have a terrible time. I just take that as an insult directly to the game. This is true if, say, you have an opinion about a game. You know, you don't like a game, other people do. We saw this with Dragon's Crown. Obviously, that one had some mixed reviews, and people were furious that some people didn't like Dragon's Crown, sometimes because of, you know, one of the criticisms being the art style. I happen to enjoy Dragon's Crown, but to me it does a disservice to the game and to the people who made the game and put the effort into the game if all we then do is focus about how unhappy some stranger on the internet's opinion made us feel about the game. The game was made to be enjoyed. Enjoy it. This isn't to say we shouldn't criticize, we shouldn't debate. Of course we should. I love a good debate, I love a good argument, but not if it's starting to make me upset, not if it's starting to make me unhappy. That's not the point of video games. The Jimquisition obviously is an angry, angry show, but I like to think that my show is all about bringing us further toward a greater enjoyment, a greater appreciation of video games. I get angry at business practices that undermine the joy of the software itself. I get angry at business practices that undermine the joy of the game-buying public. And for me, that's what it's always been about. It's been about fun, joy, having a good laugh. And that's something that I would like us to do a lot more of, is to just have a good fucking laugh. And, you know, a lot of times on Christmas episodes of things, on any sort of Christmas-themed video, the overlying message is, let's all just for one season, let's all just for one day not be a dick to each other. I would prefer instead to not just do that for a day. My theory has always been, if you need an excuse to not be a shit person, you're a shit person, you know? So maybe we should all not be shit people, not just on one day of the year, but for the whole thing. That's that. I told Greg Tito at the Escapist I'd have a video for him on Christmas Day. Seemed like a really good idea at the time. And I thought, well, I'll just sit in front of a camera and speak unscripted, which is how the Jimquisition used to be, before the Escapist, and just see what happens, and I'll do a little Christmassy speechy thing and wear a hat, which proves it's Christmas. So that's that. That's just me sat here, but just being normal Jim Sterling, having a bit of a talk. And you don't have to watch this episode if you don't want to. You probably want to eat a Christmas dinner or something, which is fine. Please do it. Have a laugh, please, God. And I mean, if you made it this far, well done to you. And I hope you got something out of it. It was just a little look back, a little bit of a warble. I'll be back on Monday the 30th of December, for the last Jimquisition of the year. That is the top 10 shittiest games of 2013. Bit ironic after I just said it's all about having fun and celebrating and having a good time, but sometimes shit things happen, and sometimes the Jimquisition, all the time the Jimquisition talks about it. Thank you. And thank you for humouring me. And thank you all for watching the Jimquisition. It's been a wonderful year this year for me. The show exploded, just sort of got three times as popular over the course of this year. And I would like to thank everybody who watches the show and has been supporting it and allowing me to keep doing it, because this is, you know, if I could just do Jimquisition and have that be my job, I would do it. But, you know, I guess the more people who watch it and the more people who share it and enjoy it, the closer that can be. So thank you again, and thank God for me.